हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू दिस सेशन ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग ग्राफिक्स एंड डिज़ाइन। माई सेल्फ विमल सलोत फ्रॉम एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सेक्शनल ऑटोग्राफिक प्रोजेक्शन विथ एन एग्जाम्पल। हियर द क्वेश्चन इज आइसोमेट्रिक व्यू ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट इज शोन इन फिगर। ड्रॉ इट्स सेक्शनल फ्रंट व्यू and top view using first angle projection method. So it is the given three dimensional object and we have to draw its front view, but front view is not normal front view. We have to draw its sectional front view and top view using first angle projection method. So according to first angle projection method, we know the arrangement of the view. Top view should be located below the front view, and according to that arrangement we have to manage the space. Now initially we will draw normal front view and top view. After drawing that, we will consider sectional view. So it is the direction for front view observer. Here you can see this symbol of arrow and this capital letter. It indicates direction for the front view. So looking from this direction, we have to decide three main dimensions of the object: length, width and height. So looking from this direction, it is total length of the object. Here it is given 100 mm. It is total width of the object. It is 50 mm, and it is total height of the object. It is given as 60 mm. So these are the three main dimensions of the object. Now let's see what are the components for this object. Here you can see it is a rectangular shape plate. This plate, base plate, is also having rectangular shape, but this hole is cut at the bottom of this plate and it is particular shape. It is known as dow tilt shaped hole. This angle is 45 degree. Here also the angle is 45 degree. Both of these angles are similar. If it is not given, then also we have to consider both of these angles as similar, 45 degree angle. It is a base plate. It is rectangular plate. In this rectangular plate, it is a cut part, and you can see the shape of this cut is semicircular. It is semicircular cut part, and this component is a rib, and it is used to increase the strength of the object. Shape is triangular shape. Now we can start drawing. So first of all, draw XY reference line. From front view direction, we can see two dimensions of the object, that is length and height. So length is 100 and height is 60. So draw a rectangle of 100 by 60 mm size, length 100, height 60. So it is a block in which we will draw front view of the object. Now from front view direction, let us try to visualize which surfaces can be seen. So here this surface is clearly visible in its true shape with this cut part. This rib is also visible from this direction, but it will look like this slant edge in front view, and this shape will look in the true shape from the front view direction. So here this edge has dimension that we have to find out, because total dimension is given as 100, but from this point to this point, what is the length is not given. Here you can see it is 20, and this dimension is 30. So 20 plus 30, 50 mm. 100 minus 50, it means that length of this bottom edge is 50 mm. So draw this bottom edge horizontal line with dimension 50 mm. From this point, it is the dimension which is given as 20 mm. So locate this point at 20 mm dimension from this corner point. Draw this horizontal edge here. It is drawn here. Length is 20 mm. Now this horizontal edge is at a distance of 10 mm from the bottom. So from this bottom line, measure 10 mm distance and draw a horizontal line as shown here. It is the horizontal line. Now this shape is clearly visible and it is in true shape, and this angle is 45 degree. So from this point, draw a line at an angle of 45 degree. Where it will intersect, that will be the end point of this slant edge. So this angle is here 45. Similarly, on other side also, from this point, draw an inclined line at an angle of 45 degree. So you have to just extend it till you get the intersecting point with this horizontal line. Write down dimension from bottom. It is 10 mm dimension. Write down angle also, 45 degree. Here, this edge is vertical edge in up to total height 60 mm. So from bottom to topmost corner point, draw a vertical line of 60 mm height. Here it is horizontal edge. This length is 30 mm. Here this length is 30 mm. It is given here. It is 30. So from this point, take dimension 30 mm. From this point, you can see it is vertical edge. So from this point, we have to draw vertical line. It is drawn here. It is vertical line. Now, what should be the height of this line? As it is not given here, but we can find, because this height is given and it is 20 mm and total is 60. So 60 minus 20, it means this height is 40. So up to 40 mm, we have to draw this vertical line. From this point, draw horizontal line. It represents this horizontal edge, this horizontal line. Now from this point, draw this vertical edge. So from this point, draw the vertical edge. Now look at this object. So it will look like a triangular shape. And this slant edge, for this slant edge, there are 2 points, first point and second point. So simply you have to join these points as shown here, first point and second point. So join both of these points. So it is a slant edge, which is shown here. And this shape, triangular shape, is represented here in front view. So it is a front view for the rib. So these all are visible details, which is clearly seen from the front view direction. Now let us see if there is any invisible detail. So when we look at this object from front view direction, there is hidden detail. It is cut part. Shape is semicircular, but from front view direction, it is not visible. So it is hidden detail, and it is represented by dotted lines in drawing. So the distance at which it is cut, so from this point, this distance is 15 mm, because diameter of this circular part is 30. So from this center point, it is a radius. Radius is 15 mm. That's why we have to take dimension from this point, 15 mm. And from 15 mm dimension, draw vertical dotted line, because this semicircular hole is cut from top to bottom. So up to the bottom part, up to the bottom line, draw the dotted line. So our front view is completed. Now for top view, take the projection from front view, and in top view we can see two dimensions. When we look at this object from top view direction, we can see length and other dimension is width. When we take projection from front view, length is obtained, and width, here it is width 50, so length 100 and width 50. By taking the dimension, draw this rectangle. Now in this rectangle, we have to draw its top view. Draw its center line, write down dimensions also, width is 50. It is very necessary to write down dimensions, but it is not necessary to repeat the dimensions. If in front view some dimensions is written, then it is not necessary to repeat it in top view. Draw the center line. We know the format for the center line. It is long dash, short dash, long dash, short dash, the center line. For symmetrical object, it becomes easy to draw the views with reference to center line. Now from top view direction, we can see the surfaces. It is a surface which is seen in two shape with the semicircular cut part. This base plate is clearly visible from the top view direction, and it will look like a rectangle. Here this rib, its true shape is triangular shape, but when we look at this rib from the top view direction, it will look like a rectangular strip with this width 10 mm. So these are the visible details, but this dovetail shaped slot which is cut at the bottom side of the base plate is not visible from top view direction. So it will become hidden detail. Now draw the projection from this part. Here it is the length 30 mm. From this point by projection we got that length 30 mm. And it is clear visible. So draw these lines. Now to draw this semicircular wall, we require to locate its center, and it is located at a distance of 15 mm. So from this hidden detail, draw the projection, so it is the center point. To draw a semicircle, keep this point as center, take radius 15 mm and draw a semicircle. This edge and this edge both are visible from top view. So complete that both of the edges. It is a rectangular base plate. Complete that rectangular base plate. Here it is completed. Now rib, when you look at this rib from top view direction, it will look like a rectangle with the width 10 mm. So take 10 mm width. This width is 10 mm from center line. You can consider 5 mm above and below the center line dimension. Total dimension is 10. So these are the visible details which can be seen from the top view direction. Now about invisible detail. Dovetail shaped hole is invisible from the top view direction. So take projection from front view. In front view it is shown here. So it is the concerned detail. Take projection line and show the hidden detail with the dotted lines. Here it is shown by the dotted lines. And throughout width it is cut. So throughout width, go to draw these dotted lines. Write down dimension for width of rib 10 mm. So it is the top view. Front view and top view both are completed. Now we have to consider the sectional front view. And for taking section, the position of the cutting plane is given in this object. It is shown here. This capital letter and arrow A and B. So it indicates that this object is being cut at this cutting plane line. So after cutting this object, the portion which is in between cutting plane and object, that portion is to be removed. And for remaining portion, we have to draw its front view. So first indicate the position of the cutting plane with CPL cutting plane line. And what is the format for cutting plane line? It is long chain, thin elsewhere, but thick at ends with two capital letters and two arrowheads. Front view is in section, so CPL is to be drawn in top view. So both of these ends are being thick, two arrowheads, two capital letters, AB, because in question CPL is drawn by AB, so it is a cutting plane AB. Now, what will be the difference between this normal front view and sectional front view? So what happens after taking section? This semicircular hole, which was invisible, but after taking section, it becomes visible. So this hidden line, this dotted line, is to be replaced with the continuous line. So that is the first change. This hidden line is replaced with continuous line. And now we have to draw the hatchings or section line. Where hatchings to be drawn? The surface or the material which is being cut by a cutting plane or section plane is to be shown by the section lines. So it is a material which is cut by the cutting plane. So draw hatchings or section line on the surface. There should be uniform spacing in between all the section lines. All the section lines are drawn at an angle of 45 degree with the base lines. So these are the hatchings. And now it becomes sectional front view. One important point you should notice is that this rib is also cut while taking section. But as it is cut along its longer section, and according to BIS, if rib is cut according at its longer section, then hatchings are not to be drawn on that surface. That's why here hatchings are not drawn. Here also this concluded point is given for rib, as it is a special case to draw hatchings. Rib is a supporting element which is used to increase the strength of the object, and when it is cut at longer section, hatchings are not drawn on that surface. Thank you very much for watching.